Use your brains if you want to protest. Why you got to use your body as an object like that?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Well, and just imagine if men started stripping to make a point.
I've never heard that before.
That's why I thought it was a little bit weird, because I just, you know, just imagine a guy going on Instagram and, you know, they're trying to make a point and take a stand.
That's a good point.
I mean, what if you guys did that? Do you think that would go over so well?
It wouldn't go over with my wife.
Nope, it would not.
I wouldn't.
Would that help, though?
No.
That's not going to do anything.
Oh, you don't think it would?
I don't think so. I mean.
Well, Emily thinks it works. The Hodge twins are here in studio with us. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having us.
How's DC treating you?
So far, so good.
Yeah, we managed to stay out of trouble.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Okay, but you still have a few days left here, so we'll see how that goes. I might see you guys in a news article somewhere.
I hope not.
I hope so. It might be a little entertaining.
Yeah.
Just hopefully it's not too terrible. So I wanted to get your take on a few things going on in the news. Right now, everyone's talking about model Emily Ratajkowski. Apparently, she stripped so that she could protest the Alabama abortion laws. She was pretty much almost nude in one of these pictures that she posted on Instagram. She had like a flower over her. I don't know if this is an effective strategy to protest something.
I don't think so either, because who hasn't seen her naked? She's always got her clothes off.
Yeah.
That's like a crackhead smoking crack to protest abortion. It doesn't make any sense.
Yeah. And also, I'm sure you guys heard about the sex strike.
Wow, if you want to protest, you can protest, but why are you going to use your body as an object? I thought women was trying to, you know, hold themselves to a higher standard.
Yeah.
Use your brains if you want to protest. Why you got to use your body as an object like that?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Well, and just imagine if men started stripping to make a point.
I've never heard that before.
That's why I thought it was a little bit weird, because I just, you know, just imagine a guy going on Instagram and, you know, they're just trying to make a point and take a stand.
That's a good point.
I mean, what if you guys did that? Do you think that would go over so well?
It wouldn't go over with my wife.
Nope, it would not.
I wouldn't.
would that help, though?
No.
That's not going to do anything.
Oh, you don't think it would?
I don't think so. I mean.
Well, Emily thinks it works.
It doesn't work, Emily.
Sorry. Well, maybe you guys should try it and see if you guys can cause a stir national debate about something. See if you can change the laws by stripping down.
Don't give me no ideas.
I mean, what do you have to lose?
Yeah, I know. Nothing, really.
Okay, I want to move on to Bill de Blasio, mayor of New York City. He's officially running for president. Is this exactly what the party of diversity needed, an old white man to run for president on their side?
He's perfect. He's tone deaf.
Yeah.
He doesn't get it. I mean, that guy's like the worst mayor in history.
Yeah, I wonder what his slogan's going to be. Make America look like New York City.
Guys, even his residents hate his guts. It's like...
Yeah. Why would you hold a rat inside of a Trump hotel?
Yeah, and everybody's holding up these Trump 2020 signs and drowning them out. That guy's a complete loser.
And he's
loser!
Yeah, you are a complete loser. And then at his rally, he's holding up these new Green Deal signs. This is the same guy that went to the gym in a helicopter.
Did he really? I didn't hear about that. I did hear that he still goes to the gym, and then he takes like black SUVs and like a whole squad with him.
Because he's burning all kinds of gas.
Yeah,
he's just to go to the gym.
Yeah, he's just trying to, you know, make it seem like he's just a regular folk going to the gym. Yeah. But like, that's not how I roll to the gym.
Yeah. Right.
I walk to the gym.
Yeah, he goes
by myself.
Secret service.
That guy is tone deaf, oblivious.
Yeah.
That guy's he's horrible presidential material.
Well, and you guys made a point that if you love New York City subway system, and if you love NYCHA housing, which is the public housing, then you would really love how he would run America. Yeah. And you're right. I think the number was like 76% of his constituents said they didn't want him to run for president. Mm-hmm. Also, his job approval rating is around like 40%, so it's pretty anemic.
Mm-hmm.
And all he has to do is manage New York City.
Yeah.
Not a whole country.
Yeah, and that place is a liberal
asshole. Don't say it. Cesspool. Don't say the other word.
And his approval rating is only 40%. That's insane.
It's like one out of six people that are like Democrats. That's like, how can you mess that up?
Who do you think told him it was a good idea to run?
I think it's probably a money grab. A lot of these Democrats, they know they're not going to win.
Yeah,
eventually. They can't. You can't be that stupid. You have no shot.
Yeah, eventually that money, you know, is going to funnel down into his bank account. But
Yeah, I think the only people that actually thought it was a good idea was himself and probably his campaign manager that's going to pocket a lot of cash.
I think his wife, too, right? I think probably much, pretty much just him. Everybody's probably telling him, hey, don't run. You suck.
And also, I was listening to his platform. Like, he has nothing else to offer.
Mm-hmm. All the candidates are right. Ideas, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, there's nothing new, fresh about what he's talking about.
Recycled liberal garbage.
Yeah, how do you even compete with, like, Trump's economy and Trump's accomplishments? So,
I know.
Like, I think, you guys, this is an attention stunt. Mm-hmm. He's going to try to sell a book off of it.
Yeah, money
and,
grab.
The beginning of his campaign video, he starts just crying and just going against, you know, rich people, like, we gotta, you know, money's going into the wrong pockets. I'm like, dude, you're worth millions.
Yeah. That's like, what's so bad about people being rich and billionaires? You take the billionaires and the rich people and entrepreneurs, you ain't got nothing.
Yeah.
You ain't got nothing.
But it's rich people that are always complaining most about other rich people.
Yeah.
Which is
so weird. But that's liberals. Regressive ideologies.
So I wanted to get your thoughts on the new measure that passed in Denver to decriminalize the use of magic mushrooms.
Denver police will now treat possession of magic mushrooms as its least priority. Between 2016 and 2018, there were only 158 arrests for possession. No more, says voter.
How do you do that? Do you sniff it? Or you smoke it?
No, I don't know.
I think you eat mushrooms.
You eat them?
Yeah.
So you just put them on a salad? I do mushrooms now.
I don't know. Wait, Richie, do you eat mushrooms or do you smoke them?
Do you eat or drink?
Do you just eat them plain?
Yeah, you can put them on a sandwich. Or
people are putting mushrooms on sandwiches?
Hey, let's get high. I'm going to make this sandwich.
peanut butter.
Wait, how do you know how much you should take? Can you die from it?
You measure it. No, you can't die.
Okay, well...
It's impossible to die, right?
You wish you was dead, though.
Wait, okay, so you guys claim you haven't used magic mushrooms?
I don't even smoke weed.
Yeah.
I'm like the only black... Well, we're the only black guys that don't smoke weed.
That's pretty racist for you to say that.
So my wife's like, what kind of black man are you? I'm the...
Uncle Tom kind.
No, I'm the... sophisticated kind. Sophisticated.
So do you think this is a step in the right direction for Denver?
Sounds like more regressive ideology to me.
Yeah, what's next, acid?
How about coke? That comes from a plant. Why not?
I mean, I don't know where they're going with this. Like I said, I've never tried mushrooms. I would be very afraid to.
From what I hear from the inner city and the youth, man, if it comes from the earth, it's good for you.
It's like I thought some mushrooms can kill you too, like the poisonous mushrooms.
I'm pretty sure. Some
like, how do you know which mushrooms are okay, Richie? How do you know which ones are good or bad?
Just gotta get the right guy.
Oh boy! So
is it illegal? It's not a. What do you find? Did it like stand on the corner with the weed guy or what?
It's not commercialized. It's just.
I think we can start our own mushroom business then. It's a huge opportunity.
Then you're gonna have to move to Denver then.